Hi, welcome to this video. Today in this video we'll discuss regarding carburetor, types of carburetors and detailed study of a Solex carburetor. Now starting with the basics, what is a carburetor? The device which is used to prepare air fuel mixture which is sent to engine cylinder, where this mixture gets burnt in order to obtain power, is called as carburetor. Where it is used? A carburetor is used in spark ignition engines, that is petrol engines. Now coming to the types, there are basically two types of carburetors. First is open choke type carburetor and second is constant vacuum type carburetor. In an open choke type carburetor, the main orifice known as choke tube or venture is of fixed dimensions and metering is affected by varying the pressure drop across it. Examples of this type of carburetor are Zenith, Solex, Carter and Stomper carburetors. In this video, we'll study regarding Solex carburetor, whereas Carter carburetor will be discussed in next video. The second type of carburetor is constant vacuum type carburetor. In this type, the area of air passage is varied automatically while the pressure drop is kept approximately constant. The example of this type of carburetor is SU carburetor, which will also be discussed in coming videos. Now forms of carburetors. There are three forms of carburetors. First is updraught, second is horizontal, third is downdraught. As you can see from the picture, when the air flows vertically in upward direction, that is called as updraught. When the air flows in horizontal direction, that is called as horizontal version. And when the air flows in vertically downward direction, that is called as downdraught. Now out of these three forms, downdraught and horizontal are most widely used. Downdraught has an advantage that mixture is assisted by gravity in its passage into the engine induction tract, and at the same time the carburetor is usually easily accessible. Whereas the advantage of horizontal version is, when the undermount space is limited, this version is more suitable. Now the third one, updraught variety, is now almost obsolete, means it is not used nowadays and it's only used when neither of the other types can be accommodated. Now today's discussion topic, Solex carburetor. This is widely used and famous for good performance, ease of starting and reliability. It is used in various models such as Fiat, standard cars and village Jeep. It also has a unique feature called bi-starter, which is used for cold starting purpose. Now the different circuits of a Solex carburetor are described further. Now before going further, I would like to explain this diagram. This is nothing but an elementary carburetor with three different attachments. This is my first attachment, this is called as bi-starter. This is my second attachment, this is called as idling system. And this is the third system attachment, that is called as acceleration pump. Now how these works, we'll study now one by one. Cold starting and warm-up condition. Now when you start your engine for the first time, that condition is called as cold start. During this you need richest mixture, means you need 5 to 10 times rich mixture as compared to your normal running. Whereas for warming, richness can be reduced to, and some lean mixture can be provided, but that should be richer as compared to normal running mixture. Now the first cold starting condition, this is my float chamber which obtains fuel from fuel tank using this tube, this channel. Once float chamber has fuel, it supplies fuel to this channel, to this bi-starter during cold start. Now in order to understand better, I have used color coding. Blue line indicates flow of fuel, brown indicates air flow line and red indicates air fuel mixture flow line. So during cold start, float chamber supplies fuel to this channel to the bi-starter at port number 9. This is a disc which is rotated by using a number 12 lever. During cold start, the driver has to pull this lever in order to rotate the disc and match the largest diameter hole of this disc with this incoming channel. This disc has number of holes of various diameters, and by pulling this lever, we engage the largest diameter hole with this incoming fuel line. Whereas port number 10 is connected to the air supply through this venture tube. So air is coming through port number 10, fuel is coming through port number 9, and here we form an air fuel mixture. After forming this mixture, this air fuel mixture is carried using this channel to port number 11. As we can see, this is our throttle valve, that is our accelerator, and your port number 11 is below it. Means even though you are not operating your throttle, you are not accelerating, your engine will get air fuel mixture. So your engine gets started. Once your engine gets started, this 12 number lever is released by the driver. Thus this disc gets rotated and smaller diameter hole gets engaged with the fuel line. Once the diameter of hole is reduced, the amount of fuel coming inside the bistarter gets reduced, but the amount of air coming inside is again same. So you have more amount of air, less amount of fuel. That means you have a lean mixture as compared to previous, and this mixture is again supplied to the engine during warming condition. Thus are the two circuits used for cold starting and warming. Now coming to idling and slow running. Now what is an idling? When you have engine running at no load condition, that is called as idling, and when you have load capacity from 0 to 20%, that is called as slow running. Now as compared to your previous, your idling requires different type of mixture. So idling does not have the same channel of fuel supply or air fuel mixture supply as the previous one. So during idling, the float chamber supplies fuel using channel number 2 to vertical channel to the port number 13. Whereas 14 number port is open to atmosphere and the air is coming inside using this port. There is a screw here which is called as idle adjust. By using this screw, we can set the amount of air coming inside our system in order to obtain desired suction pressure. Once you have air and fuel coming at this point, here you form air fuel mixture, which is then carried using this channel and given out at port number 16. Again, we can see that port number 16 is below throttle valve, means even though you are not operating your accelerator, again your engine gets some amount of air fuel mixture and it keeps running. Once you start accelerating at slow running condition, means you are having load capacity 0 to 20%, some amount of this throttle valve will be opened. Once you operate this throttle valve, some acceleration is done, then the suction at this point is reduced and your fuel air mixture starts coming out into the chamber using port number 17. So for idling condition, I have port number 16 as an output. For slow running, I have 17 as a slow running jet. So this circuit is used for idling and slow running. Now running, normal running conditions. When you have load capacity from 20 to 75% of total load, then that kind of condition is called as normal running. Now during normal running, we don't need a rich mixture, we need a lean mixture. So the fuel should be less as compared to previous conditions. Now during this, again the float chamber uses the same second channel for supplying the fuel, but it is given to the well number 4. Now this well is storing the fuel, and the side walls of this well has holes which are maintained at atmospheric pressure. So here in this well, you have emulsification process, means you have an emulsion of petrol. Now what is emulsion? It is a mixture of two immiscible liquids, means air is getting mixed with fuel, that is your petrol, but it is not getting mixed, you have different particles. This emulsified mixture is stored in well number 4 and the air is coming inside using port number 5. This incoming air creates a suction pressure and this emulsified petrol is again ejected and gets sucked by this and gets evaporated. So once you have formed a mixture, this air fuel mixture at a suction pressure, desired suction pressure is given out from port number 6. And this is how your air fuel mixture is carried, and during normal running this 7 number throttle is opened to a certain value and this is the passage taken to the engine. So this is regarding your normal running conditions. Now if you have an acceleration condition, means you have suddenly accelerated, so you need a richer mixture in order to cope up with the instantaneous load and in order to generate more power. Now the mixture which is prepared and fed during normal running condition is not capable of producing instantaneous power, means you need additional fuel. Now what is the reason for this? As we all know, as the atomization process takes place in this carburetor, even though after the atomization process some amount of fuel is present in liquid state which is carried in the same state to the engine cylinder where it is getting evaporated before the compression stroke. But in order to obtain instantaneous power, you need more amount of atomization, means you have to supply additional amount of fuel. Now that work is done by acceleration pump. How it works? So when you have to press this acceleration pedal, then lever number 19 moves towards left, thus forcing this diaphragm against the spring. When the spring is forced or pressurized, the fuel which is contained in this chamber starts ejecting itself or starts moving from this channel number 20 to port number 18, and an additional jet is sprayed inside this venturi tube along with the normal working of your venturi tube. Means you have this jet at number 6 port and an additional jet is given at port number 18, and this is instantaneously done once you have suddenly accelerated. The moment you release the pedal, lever number 19 moves toward right, thus your diaphragm is again back to at original position because of this spring force. Because of this movement of diaphragm towards right, there is a suction created at this point and the control valve is opened. Once the control valve is opened, float chamber starts supplying some fuel to this passage and it is stored here. It will be utilized for next acceleration. So this is how your acceleration channel works. This was all about your Solex carburetor. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it.